Wrapping up his first visit to Sri Lanka as the Foreign Secretary of India, Harshvardhan Shringla met with President Gotabaya Rajapaksa. This is the fourth and final day of Sri Lanka's maiden trip. Over the last 3 days, Shringla met with the Sri Lankan Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa, Finance Minister Basil Rajapaksa, the Foreign Minister Professor G.L. Pierres, and also held talks with the Sri Lankan Foreign Secretary. Sri Lanka occupies a central place in India's neighbourhood first policy, and the visit signifies the importance the two countries attach to strengthening their ties. A media release issued by Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa's office following the meeting with Harshvardhan Shringla said India is looking forward to receiving the first pilgrims flight from Sri Lanka to India's Kushinagar Airport. Kushinagar is a popular destination for Buddhist pilgrims, which has now been upgraded to an international airport. During his virtual bilateral summit with the Prime Minister Rajapaksa last year, Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced a $15 million grant for the promotion of Buddhist ties. The grant was aimed at deepening people-to-people linkages between the two sides. In his meeting with the Indian Foreign Secretary, Prime Minister Rajapaksa appreciated Prime Minister Modi's initiative to promote Buddhist ties. On Monday, the Foreign Secretary virtually launched a few India-backed projects from Colombo. He handed over 1,200 houses to Tamil minority beneficiaries under the third phase of the Indian Housing Project. Foreign Secretary Shringla also met with the Tamil leaders on Monday. Remember that Sri Lanka is a predominantly Buddhist country, with Tamils being a minority. During his meeting, Sri Lanka emphasized on India's commitment to protecting the rights of Tamils living in Sri Lanka. Earlier on Sunday, Secretary Shringla inspected Jaffna's airport in Sri Lanka's northern province, where development work is taking place with India's assistance. He also visited the iconic Jaffna Cultural Center, which was built with Indian grant assistance. Shringla also visited the Trincomalee Oil Tank Farm, a key India-Sri Lanka economic partnership link. The World War II era oil storage facility has been crucial to New Delhi-Colombo ties. The Foreign Secretary's visit will provide India an opportunity to review the progress of ongoing bilateral projects and ongoing cooperation to tackle COVID-19 related issues. Earlier this year, India supplied COVID-19 vaccines to Sri Lanka under its Vaccine Maitri initiative. For more on this, our correspondent Dasuni Athoda sent us this report from Colombo. Take a look.
The Indian Foreign Secretary met with President Gotabaya Rajapaksa on his final day of the tour of Sri Lanka. And during the past few days, we did see the Indian Foreign Secretary visit the cities of Kandy, Trincomalee and Jaffna, in addition to the capital of Colombo here. Also yesterday, the Indian Foreign Secretary did meet with Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa, as well as the Minister of Finance, and also initiated four programs in the housing and education sector with the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Professor G.L. Pierres. Now, matters of mutual understanding, mutual importance, as well as diplomatic relations between India and Sri Lanka were looked at during this tour. So that's it for the tour of the Foreign Secretary here in Sri Lanka. Another important event that we will look forward to is the Mitra Shakti military exercise between India and Sri Lanka, which is currently underway, where Sri Lanka is expecting the visit of the Indian Army Chief in the coming days as well. Reporting for We On World is One, I'm Dasuni Athoda.
We On, now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.